Bayside at Waterman's, Galveston's coastal concierge and luxury community overlooking Lake Como and West Galveston Bay. Relax by the resort-style pool, float the lazy river, or fish from the community's boardwalk or fishing pier. Store your boat at the community's covered 127-slip marina. Kayakers and canoeists can launch from the marina on Lake Como or the state park to explore the tranquility of Galveston Bay. Bayside at Waterman's, a rare coastal treasure. For more, call 1-844-9-BAYSIDE. Bayside at Waterman's in beautiful Galveston, Texas. Tempe Diablo Stadium is a site of the 28th annual Men's Senior Baseball League's World Series, and this evening from Tempe, Arizona, it's the Boston Wolfpack taking on the Houston Old Stars. And a pleasant good evening to everybody, and welcome. I'm Jeff Lowry with APN Video Sports, where tonight a reunion between two outstanding Major League players. One, of course, Roger Clemens, over 350 wins in his career, a seven-time Cy Young Award winner, and he's going up against a guy that he pitched with during the 1986 Boston Red Sox run for a World Championship, and Dennis Oil Can Boyd. The two pitchers combined for 40 wins on that 86 season. Steve Wolf is the manager of the Boston Wolfpack. He has been bringing teams down here to Phoenix for nearly two decades, and I had a chance to talk to his starting pitcher earlier today. What's this experience like for you going up against your old teammate from the Boston Red Sox, Roger Clemens?
Well, I hope it's going to be some fun tonight. I'm looking forward to it. Like I said, it wasn't a planned event. I was coming out to play with these guys in the first place, and I found out that Roger was going to be here and that we were going to be paired up to pitch for each ball club. So then a little excitement came in. Plus, at the same time, I'm looking forward to seeing him. We're very close and hadn't been on the ball field together in a long time.
What was it like? You guys were in that 86 World Series. You guys combined for 40 wins that year. That was a great season. What was it like playing with Roger as a teammate?
Great teammate to have. Very competitive within his own, but personally just a great, great friend too as well. So the years that I spent with him, 6 or 7 years or so, I enjoyed every day. We learned a lot from each other. Two different kind of pitches, of course, but at the same time, we talked the game of baseball. He was considered, to me, he would be the greatest power pitcher of all time, to me. His accomplishments are great and far better than a lot of people that are in the Hall of Fame right now. And you can say whatever you want. To me, he's a great guy and was a great competitor, and that's why you win 300 ball games and 7 Cy Youngs. That's how you do it.
You've been playing, like you said, in this league and in different tournaments for 7 years. Roger hasn't had quite that much experience over the last 5 or 6 years. You think you got a little advantage on him today?
No, I don't think so. I think that his natural ability to just, take place, and, if we come out and we compete, even 60% of what he would do and I would do would be enough to go out and win a ball game for either side. So that's basically all there is to it. A little rust on him don't mean anything.
On the other side, the Houston Old Stars, led by their manager Todd Edwards, they are very talented. They have three former Major League players, including Roger Clemens. I caught up with Roger yesterday when they played the Tri-Valley 40s over at Goodyear Ballpark. Can you give us a little backstory how this all came about?
Well, I got a couple close friends on the Houston team, and they called me a few weeks back and gave me a little heads up. And I think they were probably surprised when I told them, yeah, I'll come out and play a few games with them. And playing the other guys from, I think they're from California, the Bay Area, some real scrappy hitters and some fun guys. I mean, it was good to get back on the bump. You just want to kind of take it a little easy so you don't pull anything. But I think it's great. It's good exercise for these guys and help them stay young and get out there and have a little fun.
They came out pretty aggressive, and they seem pretty confident going up against such a great pitcher like yourself.
Yeah, well, like I said, we're all a little bit more advanced in our age, and the guys seem like they enjoy it. Again, the field was just a little bit wet, but we're lucky that we're able to get to play on it. They did some good work on it, so we could, and I think everybody's enjoying themselves. There's a few tight hamstrings and tight backs out there, but for the most part, everybody's pretty competitive and it seems like they're having fun.
Now, tomorrow you are going up against a former teammate in Oil Can Boyd. Tell us a little bit about your relationship with him down through the years.
Well, I had a great relationship with all my teammates, and especially Oil Can. He was a great competitor out there on the mound, and boy, we won some really big games together in Boston. We had some great teams in Boston, so it'd be fun to see him out there. And you know, I've seen him a few times at different functions up in New England or at Fenway, and we just had a great time. So it'd be fun to see Can out there doing his thing.
So when we come back, we'll have all the exciting play-by-play action. It's Houston and Boston coming up next here from Tempe Diablo Stadium. It's the Men's Senior Baseball League's World Series. Welcome back to Tempe Diablo Stadium. The Wolfpack getting set to take on the Houston Old Stars. Houston coming in with a record of 3 wins and 1 loss. Their only loss came at the hands of the San Antonio Bombers. The Wolfpack come in winning their first 2 games in round-robin play, but losing earlier today to defending champion Team Victory. So the Rocket, Roger Clemens, taking his final warm-up tosses, 354 career wins, second most by a right-handed pitcher in the live ball era. That's topped by only the great Hall of Famer Greg Maddux. We're in the 50 and over American Division as the Wolfpack will send up right fielder Mark Moyes. He'll be followed by Jose Delgado and their third baseman Germán Rivera. For this 5:30 start time, Tempe Diablo Stadium, the much-anticipated Roger Clemens versus Dennis Oil Can Boyd game. This is the 28th annual MSBL World Series, and Mark Moyes lines a base hit into right field on the very first pitch from Roger Clemens, and this game is underway. Well, Mark Moyes will be talking about this moment for the rest of his life. What a great moment for the leadoff hitter of the Boston Wolfpack. And now the batter is going to be Jose Delgado. Delgado, an excellent second place hitter who handles the bat extremely well. Clemens throw over to first, the runner back in easily. The Wolfpack have been in a national championship game of the MSBL World Series a grand total of 5 times. They won it back in 2008, but they've had losses in 03, 09, and the last 2 seasons. Last year, they lost 12-5 to Team Victory. As I mentioned earlier, that was the team that they played earlier today and lost 11-3. Runner at first, leadoff hitter aboard, and Mark Moyes. Clemens' first pitch is low and inside. Ball one to Jose Delgado. Yesterday, the Houston Old Stars played Tri-Valley, the regular scheduled game, in defeating them 8-4. But Roger Clemens pitched 3 innings in the continuation game, which was played before the scheduled game. There's a swing and a miss. Here's the runner heading down to second, and Mark Moyes has an easy stolen base. So 1-1 on Jose Delgado. And the question I've been asked is just how many innings will Roger Clemens and Dennis Oil Can Boyd pitch here today? I would imagine Dennis Oil Can Boyd will try to go as far as he can. He's got what you call in the business a rubber arm. Clemens pitched 3 innings yesterday. I would imagine that we will not see 8 or 9 innings. I don't think we'll see a complete game, no matter how dominant he may be here today. As that pitch is a called strike on the outside corner, and it's 1-2. But I would imagine he's gonna give us some innings here today, and I probably somewhere between 5, 6, or 7. So Delgado up there, he's got 2 strikes and holding, and he swings and chops one towards the shortstop, Todd Edwards, who's up and throws and got him at first base, and that's the first out of the ball game. So Mark Moyes holds up at second base. Nice play by the shortstop. And with one out, here is the third baseman, Germán Rivera. Top of the first, no score. Boston batting. Rivera, one of the top run producers on this Boston Wolfpack lineup in the third position. You got Dodger, former Dodger farmhand on deck in Larry C. So Moyes takes his lead out at second. Clemens rocks and deals, and a chopping ball foul third base side, and it's nothing and one on Rivera. Defensively for Boston, or check that, defensively for Houston, Mike Scanlon at first base. Greg McMeans is at second. Todd Edwards, who just made a play at shortstop, and former starting pitcher in the MLB, Woody Williams is at third. Geegan in left, McCray center, and Jeff McMeans is in right field. That one is slapped to the right side. Two strikes on Germán Rivera, with Robert Schwartz doing the catching and the rocket. Roger Clemens, who last pitched on September 16, 2007. There is a connection with he and his teammate here today, and Tom Arrington, who coaches the San Jacinto Junior College team, where Roger started his college career. Here's a looping fly ball. McCray will not have a play on it. The throw comes back in quickly as Scanlon dives for it, the first baseman, and they're on the corner. So a couple of hits given up by Clemens here in the top of the first inning. Rivera at first, Moyes at third, and now the cleanup hitter is Larry C. Larry was drafted by the Los Angeles Dodgers in the third round of the 1980 amateur draft. That was in January of 1980. So Roger has given up a couple of hits here in the first. They're on the corners with one out. Boston trying to draw first blood, and the first pitch is a fastball, and they will appeal to first base. He did not go, and it's one ball and no strikes on Larry C. Coming to you from Diablo Stadium in Tempe, Arizona, infield not quite at double play depth. So Clemens dealing to Larry C. There goes the runner. The pitch is taken for a ball, and an easy steal for Jose Delgado. Courtesy running for Germán Rivera. As Clemens looks back at the runner, and now second and third with one man out here in the top of the first inning. We were talking about Roger Clemens, his junior college days in Texas, as this ball is ripped down to Woody Williams. He's up with it. He throws home, and they got him. Gunning down the lead runner in Mark Moyes, and an outstanding play by the former St. Louis Cardinal pitcher, Woody Williams, who won 18 games for Tony La Russa in 2003. He got down on that ball. Outstanding job making sure that he came up with the ball and then fired a strike to home plate. So there's two down here in the inning. Don Cuff, courtesy running at first base, and now the Wolfpack backstop, Dean Borelli, digs in. Dean was drafted by the Oakland A's in the 20th round of the 1988 June amateur draft. He takes ball one. Played ball at the University of Massachusetts. There's a half a dozen players on this Wolfpack roster that was drafted by major league teams. Including Dennis Oil Can Boyd. Swung on, fly ball, foul, out of play. So runners are at second and third. Jose Delgado, the courtesy runner, out at second base. Check that, runners are at first and second. And here's the pitch. And here's a swing and a ground ball to Woody Williams. He's got it in the hole. He's up. He throws the one-hop throw to Scanlon, and that'll retire the side. No runs, two left. And after a half an inning of play, Boston nothing and Houston coming up. Dennis Oil Can Boyd will now take the mound for the Boston Wolfpack. had a 10-year major league career where he posted 77 victories and an ERA just over 4. Spent many years with the Boston Red Sox, and he'll be going up against another former major league player in Rodney McCray. Bottom of the first inning, Boston failed to score after two were on. And now the speedy Rodney McCray, who played his junior college ball at Santa Monica Junior College. He swings and misses at Oil Can Boyd's first offering, and it's 0-1. Of course, known for crashing through a wall in right field during his minor league days, better than 20 years ago, on a ball that was hit by current manager, as this one's popped up third base side. Opportunity time for Germán Rivera, and he takes care of McCray for out number one. Ironically, Chip Hale is the one that hit that, and you could easily find it on YouTube. It was a miraculous play by Rodney McCray as Todd Edwards digs in here for the Houston Old Stars. One out, nobody on, no score, and he swings at the first pitch and fouls it off. Good cut there by Todd Edwards. Edwards, currently president of Stonehenge Real Estate Investment Company. And, of course, that Bayside at Waterman's a proud sponsor of today's game. He played his college ball at Texas A&M. And he's up there with nobody on in the bottom of the first inning, no score. And he swings and lines one to the second baseman, and Collins can't make the play. He climbed the ladder, but that ball was over the outstretched glove of the second baseman, John Collins, and the first hit of the ball game for Houston belongs to Todd Edwards. He's at first base for third baseman Woody Williams. In Woody Williams' major league career, which debuted with the Toronto Blue Jays back in 1993, he won 132 games, and as I mentioned earlier, 18-9 for that 2003 St. Louis Cardinals led by manager Tony La Russa. Lives in Houston. Played ball at the University of Houston. He takes a strike, and it's 0-1. Todd Edwards with a wrong field single. He's at first base. That's high and tight, and it's 1-1 on Williams. Williams has made the key play in this game by gunning down what would have been the first run of the game on a ground ball off the bat of Larry C. Here's a shot to first. Easy play for Larry C. He steps on the bag, and that'll retire the sides. No runs, one hit, nobody left on. At the end of one inning of play, Boston nothing, Houston likewise. This is the 28th annual MSBL World Series on APN. Heading now to the top of the second inning, no score. Paul Russo will start things off. He is a 6A hitter. John Collins, the second baseman, will bat second, and then Russ Ward third. Top of the second, no score. Russo, a strong right-handed hitter, and Edwards, the shortstop, playing deep at short. Breaking ball by Roger Clemens, and his second inning of work is in there for a called strike, 0-1. Well, Boston had a pair of hits in the first inning, but left two. Clemens rocks to the wind and delivers a sinking pitch that's under the knees, and it's 1-1 on Paul Russo. Now, one of the quirky rules of the Men's Senior Baseball League is that you can actually split a position in the lineup, as that one's in there for a called strike, 1-2. So in this situation, Paul Russo is the 6A hitter. Then the next time around in the order, the manager of the Boston Wolfpack, Steve Wolf, will bat in the 6B position. Here's a 1-2 offering. That one's bounce foul. 1-2 and holding on Paul Russo. Top of the second inning, no score. Boston batting. Pivotal game, especially for the Wolfpack, trying to get back to the championship game for a third consecutive year. And that hasn't happened since the Tri-Valley teams did it some 7 or 8 years ago. Ground ball to the right side, easy play for Scanlon. And there's one down here in the top of the second inning. John Collins, second baseman, will now face the future Hall of Famer. Here's a chopper to Edwards, his second try. He gobbles it up. Quick throw to first base, and a long scoop there by Scanlon in time, out number two. So a fine play on both ends, Edwards to Scanlon. Two quick outs here in inning number two, and the batter's going to be Russ Ward. Swings and fouls it off. Nothing in one on Russ Ward. He is the 8A hitter. Miguel Franquez will be the 8B hitter next time around. And they are going AB from the 6th position through to the 10th position. No score. Top of the second. Two out. Nobody on. Clemens delivering. And Russ Ward finds himself in an 0-2 hole against Roger Clemens. 354 career wins, nearly 4,700 strikeouts, and is one of only three American League pitchers to win the Cy Young Award and the Most Valuable Player in the same year. So there's your trivia question. Who are the other two? One just happened a couple of years ago as Clemens kicks and fires. That one's chopped foul. Roger also became the 21st pitcher in Major League history to win 300 games. And he's the owner of 5 strikeout titles. Sinking fastball. By Russ Ward with a good eye, and he laid off that pitch. A ball and 2 strikes with 2 out and nobody on here in the top of the second inning. And Russ Ward at the plate trying to get something started against Roger the Rocket Clemens, who is originally out of Dayton, Ohio. Taking his time out there on the mound, he kicks, he deals, and it's swung on and hammered to deep left field. But that ball's going to be caught. Nice catch out in left field by Fred Geegan. And the second inning, at least the top half, is in the books. We head to the home half of inning number two. Houston coming up. Scoreless tie. Jeff Lowry back here, bottom half of inning number two, and the talented Mike Scanlon at the plate. Houston old scores got a one-out single by Todd Edwards in the first inning, but he was doubled off on a line drive by Woody Williams. Here's another opportunity by Larry C., and he'll take care of Scanlon on the first pitch from Oil Can Boyd, and there's one down, and here's Roger Clemens batting for the first time here tonight. We're coming to you from Tempe Diablo Stadium. Clemens bats with nobody on and one out here in the home half of the second. The first pitch is swung on and a base hit into left field. Well, Oil Can Boyd served one up and Roger Clemens bounced one through the hole between short and third, and the second hit of the day for Houston. And now Roger having a little fun with his former teammate, Dennis Oil Can Boyd. Fred Geegan, a multifaceted ball player. We saw him playing third base in yesterday's game against Tri-Valley, and here today he's getting the start in left field, a good hitter. So Roger Clemens, a .173 major league batting average, gets a base hit off Oil Can Boyd to start with one out here in the second inning. And now Freddie Geegan takes high, ball one. Also played at Texas A&M and got as high as A ball. Works in the paper products business. As I said, a good hitter. You got to be careful here as the pitch is high to Fred Geegan. No score, home half of inning number two. It's Clemens against Oil Can Boyd, the premier event of the 28th annual MSBL World Series, and it's all on APM Video Sports. Swing and a miss, and a great breaking pitch that time by Oil Can Boyd. Give you the defense. Larry C. at first base, Collins at second, Frank was at short, Rivera at third, Benedict is in left field, the manager of the Wolfpack, Steve Wolf in center, Mark Moyes is in right field with Borelli catching, and Boyle can, long drive, deep center field, over the head of Wolf. That's going to be extra bases. The courtesy runner, Scanlon for Clemens, goes from first to third, and it's a two-base hit for Fred Gegan. So Houston is mounting a rally here in the bottom of the second inning against Oil Can Boyd, and I'll tell you what, he stayed inside that pitch and drove it over the center fielder's head. Wolf may have been playing a bit too shallow on that last play, so second and third occupied for the Houston Old Stars. The batter is going to be Greg McMeans. McMeans works for the company of Train. He's a systems integration engineer. He's got a chance to drive in some runs here. So Oil Can Boyd giving up a one-out single to Roger Clemens. That pitch is taken low for ball one to Greg McMeans. Noel Torres is on deck. Gegan takes his lead at second. Second and third, one out. The pitch. And the breaking ball. And a called strike evens the count on Greg McMeans. Now we're in the 50 and over American League of this 2015 MSBL World Series. To many of you, the American League means nothing. That is the highest skill level, at least in the 50 age group of this MSBL World Series. Breaking pitch in there, and that one, well, I would have to say a major league breaking ball right there. Gutsy pitch that time by Dennis Oil Can Boyd, who spent 10 years in the major leagues. Had three really outstanding seasons. As this one's line foul down the line, in 1985, Oil Can Boyd went 15 wins, 3.70 ERA, and appeared in 272 innings. The following year, when Boston went to the World Series in 1986, he was a 16-game winner and appeared in 214 innings. After moving on to Montreal in 1990, he was 10-6 that year by way of record, a splendid 2.93 earned run average, and appeared in 190 innings. That one is swung on and lifted foul down the left side and out of play. That was his best earned run average in his career. And he finished with 78 victories and a 404 earned run average. Pretty good career. Two-strike pitch is swung on and missed. Came back with a high fastball that was tailing away from Greg McMeans. Two down here in the second inning, and now Noel Torres. Torres is a guy you really cannot afford to be complacent with. This is a solid hitter that can hit to all fields. We saw him in yesterday's action. And don't be fooled with the fact that he's hitting in the number eight position. No score with second and third occupied, two out. Oil Can Boyd, the former Boston Red Sox, on the mound, and the pitch is high. Oil Can, of course, played for Boston for many years, spent a short time in Texas. Of course, as we mentioned, had that 10-6 season with Montreal in 1990 where he had a 293 earned run average. And here's a ball hit out into center field, a base hit. Wolf charges. He's going to throw to the plate. It's going to be high. Two runs are going to score, and the Old Stars lead it 2-0 on Noel Torres. Two runs, single to center field. Well, some clutch hitting, especially with two outs. And now the ninth place hitter coming up, Jeff McMeans, the brother of Greg. Runner at second base, a two-run inning, 2-0 Houston. The fastball by Oil Can way inside ball one. So the Old Stars have strung together three hits. And lead 2-0 here in the top of the second. Here's a rocket hit to the shortstop, knocked down by Franquez. He's up. He throws, not in time. The one-hop throw gets away from Larry C., and the third run of the inning will score. It's going to be a throwing error on the shortstop. And it is now 3-0 Houston over Boston here in the bottom half of inning number two. No RBI will be given to Jeff McMeans. Runner in Torres scores on the throwing error. And now Robert Schwartz, the starting catcher, played some third base yesterday and tries to bunt at a pitch that was up near his shoulders, and he's down 0-1. They're going to rule that an infield hit, but no RBI for Jeff McMeans, the fourth hit of the inning and the fifth hit of the day for Houston, who now leads it 3-0, home half of inning number two. And now Robert Schwartz, the catcher, finds himself down 0-2. Schwartz is Woody Williams' cousin, by the way. He is a principal at Grant Thornton School in the Houston area. And here's the 0-2 pitch. Breaking ball swung on and missed. Was not a foul tip. And now the catcher throws to second, and he didn't realize that there was two outs in the inning. So runners will be at first and second. A mental mistake by Dan Borelli. And we go back to the top of the Houston order and left-handed hitting center fielder Rodney McCray. Rodney is 0-1. He popped up in foul territory to Germán Rivera, the third baseman for Boston. So a three-run inning for Houston here in the bottom of the second inning, and they're looking for more. First and second, two outs. And the pitch is inside for ball one. Rodney McCray swinging and missing. Good breaking pitch that time by Dennis Oil Can Boyd. Well, right now, two of the three runs that he has given up are earned runs. Breaking ball, that's low, 1-2. Jeff McMeans takes his lead at second base. Robert Schwartz, who struck out but reached first base safely, is at first, and the pitch. And that one looked awfully good. And now it is two balls and two strikes. Oil Can Boy, two balls, two strikes, two out, two on. And a swing and a miss. That ball went flying down the first baseline. And the side is retired. Rodney McCray is out on strikes. And at the end of two, Houston bolts out to a 3-0 lead. This is the 28th annual MSBL World Series.
Bayside at Waterman's, Galveston's coastal concierge and luxury community overlooking Lake Como and West Galveston Bay. Relax by the resort-style pool, float the lazy river, or fish from the community's boardwalk or fishing pier. Store your boat at the community's covered 127-slip marina. Kayakers and canoeists can launch from the marina on Lake Como or the state park to explore the tranquility of Galveston Bay. Bayside at Waterman's, a rare coastal treasure. For more, call 1-844-9-BAYSIDE. Bayside at Waterman's in beautiful Galveston, Texas.
Third inning action back here, Tempe Diablo Stadium. The Clemens Oil Can Boyd game of the 28th annual MSBL World Series. Dave Benedict, the left fielder for Boston, will be the first batter to face Clemens here in the top of the third. 3-0 Houston as Clemens winds and delivers, and the breaking ball is in there for a called strike, and it's 0-1. It'll be Benedict, Bastain, and Moyes. He swings and lifts one into the air. Shallow right coming in and now backing up the right fielder and able to make the play for the first out is the Houston right fielder, one down. Well, may have lost that ball in the lights. So Benedict is retired and first time up for Carmelo. The Rocket. First pitch. And a called strike, and he's got that breaking ball over two consecutive hitters on the first offering. Houston scored three times in the second off Oil Can Boyd, and they lead it 3-0. Slider down and away, and it's 1-1. There's Roger Clemens, pitched for the Texas College program back in 1983. Had tremendous success with that program. I think many of you remember his 20-strikeout game against the Seattle Mariners. Line drive foul down the line. And Carmelo now in a one-ball, two-strike count. Carmelo played for the 1978 Gulf Coast League Pirates. And he lives in Boston. A first baseman by trade. And he swings and chops one foul to the right side again. So the count holds on the final hitter in the batting order here for Steve Wolf and his Wolf Pack, the 10th place hitter in the lineup. A ball and two strikes. Well, the big hit in this ball game was the two-run double by Noel Torres in that three-run second for Houston. And Carmelo just continues to battle up there at the plate, fighting off tough pitch after pitch from Roger Clemens. Roger working very slowly in this, his second consecutive day that he's pitched. He pitched three innings yesterday against Tri-Valley in a 4-3 win at Goodyear Ballpark. That's low and away. And according to the body English of the Houston catcher, Robert Schwartz, I think he thought that was strike three. Carmelo gets new life. The Rocket kicks and deals. And a swing and a miss, and he goes down on strikes. Two down here in the third inning. We go back to the top of the order. Mark Moyes, who singled on the very first offering by Roger Clemens back in the first inning. That's how this game led off. And the breaking ball is high, and it's one ball, no strikes on the right fielder of the Boston Wolfpack. Boston comes in with a record of 2-1. For the Old Stars, they only have one game remaining after today. They come in with a record of 3-1. 2-0 to the leadoff hitter, the Boston Wolfpack. Clemens versus Boyd from Diablo Stadium, Tempe, Arizona, the spring training home of the Anaheim Angels. And here's a bouncing ball to Woody Williams. He charges and throws to first base in a three-up, three-down inning for Roger Clemens and the Houston Old Stars. Middle of the third coming up. Houston 3, Boston nothing. And welcome back to Tempe Diablo Stadium. Bottom half of inning number 3. Oil Can Boyd will be facing Todd Edwards of the Houston Old Stars. He's 1-for-1. Edwards takes the first offering for ball one. Edwards played college ball and as high as A ball in the professional ranks, and he is ahead in the count at 2-0. The 2, 3, and 4 hitters for the Old Stars will be Edwards, Williams, and Scanlon, then Clemens to follow if they get that far. Here's a swing and a drive, deep right center field. Wolf gives chase, and Todd Edwards strolls into second, and he's got a 2-base hit. Well, a good way to start off the third inning for the Houston Old Stars. Edwards with a double to the gap in right center field, and the batter's going to be Woody Williams. Williams hit a soft line drive right at the Boston first baseman, Larry C., and the ball was hit almost right on top of the first base bag, and there was really nothing Todd Edwards could do. By the time the ball got to the first baseman, he had about a half a step, applied his foot to the bag and turned the unassisted three double play. That's how the first inning ended for Houston. Woody Williams facing Dennis Oil Can Boyd. I'll tell you what, you'd have a pretty good starting rotation here with the players that are participating in tonight's game. Roger Clemens, Woody Williams, and Oil Can Boyd. I'll tell you, there's not a general manager around that wouldn't take that, as Williams hits one down to Larry C. Nice play, and the quick flip over to Oil Can covering the bag. And on the play, Todd Edwards, will head over to third base. So Edwards 90 feet away from putting the Old Stars up 4-0. And now the cleanup hitter for Houston is Mike Scanlon, the first baseman. 3-0 Houston. We're in the home half of inning number three. Scoring three times in the second inning. Let's see what Scanlon can do. He's 0-1. First pitch from Oil Can is swung on and popped up on the infield. Franquez is under it, and he's got it, and that is a huge out for the Boston Wolfpack. So the second out of the inning recorded by the shortstop, Franquez, and now the second time up for Roger Clemens. First pitch is taken low for ball one to the Rocket. He had a single, and his courtesy runner came around to score in the second. That's taken low. Two balls and no strikes to William Roger Clemens. Well, Ken goes into the wine, and here's a looping fly ball over the shortstop's head. The second baseman cannot make a play on it, and the fourth run of the game is going to score. Houston leads 4-0 on an RBI single, a bloop single to center field by Roger Clemens. Clemens will get the courtesy runner once again. It'll be Mike Scanlon, the first baseman. So Clemens 2-for-2 with a pair of singles, and now Freddie Geegan. Geegan had a double back in the second inning. He is 1-for-1. He takes a strike. First pitch offering from Oil Can Boyd, who has done a nice job of getting that first pitch breaking ball over, which, as I always say, tends to add a few feet to the fastball. Another breaking pitch that nips the outside corner. Nothing and two the count on Geegan, the sixth place hitter in the lineup for the Houston Old Stars, who lead it 4-0 here in the home half of inning number three. The 0-2 pitch. And he swings and pops it up. That one's out of play. And the count holds at nothing and two. So Oil Can Boyd giving up a run on two hits here in the third. The pitch to Geegan, and he swings and rifles one out of play back over towards our booth here at Tempe Diablo Stadium, spring training home of the Anaheim Angels. Houston Old Stars coming in here with a record of 3 wins and 1 loss, defeating Tri-Valley twice, who has won more championships in this age group than any other team in World Series history. That one's a changeup low and inside. Boston, if they can advance to the final game this year in this 50 and over American division, it will be the third straight year they've been to that game. Pitch. And that one just missing. High and away on Geegan. Runner at first, two out. A 4-0 Houston lead here in the bottom half of inning number three. And the pitch is a bouncing ball where the shortstop, Franquez, has it. And he'll throw on to first, taking care of Fred Geegan and the third inning. We're heading to the fourth. It's Houston 4-0. Jose Delgado will start things off for the Boston Wolfpack. We are in the top of the fourth inning. Houston got 3 runs in the second, 1 more in the bottom half of the third inning as we go to the top of the fourth, as the Old Stars lead the Wolfpack 4-0. In a pivotal game in this 50 and over American League game, in which the first pitch by Clemens to Delgado is in there for a called strike. Boston
really needing a victory. He would hate to fall to the 2-2 record. That one's bounced away. Foul ball. Well, the inning that's really separating these two teams was that three-run second by Houston. Two-run double by or single by Noel Torres. Another run came in on an errant throw by the Boston shortstop, which turns out to be an unearned run. And Dennis Oilcan gave up an earned run in the third when Todd Edwards led the inning off with a two-base hit to right center field. And then two outs later, Roger Clemens hit a looping fly ball to center field to score Edwards from second base. And now you're up to date, 4-0 Houston. It'll be Jose Delgado, Rivera, and Larry C. Of course, today's game brought to you by Bayside at Waterman's, a new real estate community, luxury community down in the Galveston Bay, Galveston, Texas. And did he go around on that? They will appeal, and apparently he did not. So Clemens has run the string out on Jose Delgado, the number two hitter for Boston. They come in 2-1 with victories over Tri-Valley 7-4 and over the San Antonio Bombers 15-3, but losing to team victory 11-3 earlier today. That was a morning game. And Jose Delgado really battling with Roger Clemens as he gets that pitch count up. And with his Boston team down 4-0, Delgado will get on any way possible. He levels the bat a couple of times as Clemens brings it plateward. And that one is hammered right at the second baseman. Fine play out number one. Well, a tremendous play by the second baseman, Greg McMeans. Third place hitter is Herman Rivera. Now we got a good crowd here in our broadcast area on the concourse here at Tempe Diablo Stadium. We better than, I would say, approaching 500 people here at the ballpark. Sinker is low for ball one, or did he call that a strike? I believe he called that strike one. Rivera had a base hit back in the first inning. Boston had two hits in the first off Roger Clemens, but since then they have not seen the fruits of success. That's low, and it's one ball, one strike on the third baseman, Herman Rivera, with Larry C. on deck. We're in the fourth inning, 4-0 Houston over Boston as they bat here with one out and nobody on base. Clemens kicks and deals. Chop foul at the plate, and it's 1-2. Eight in a row set down by Roger Clemens. Check that, nine in a row set down by Roger Clemens. Going back to the first inning. So Rivera kind of regrouping before he digs back in against one of the greatest pitchers in baseball history. Here's a 1-2 pitch. And a chopper down to third, Williams. And he'll juggle it a couple of times, and the runner will be safe. Well, he might have taken his eye off the ball there. He juggles it, and they're going to rule that an error against the third baseman of the Boston, or the Houston Old Stars. All right, cleanup hitter Larry C. at the plate. So that breaks a string of nine in a row set down by the Rocket. It's the Houston Old Stars 4, the Wolfpack of Boston nothing. Strike called on a good fastball, about 86 miles per hour. And it's nothing and one on Larry C. He was drafted by the Dodgers back in 1980. Ready with an 0-1 pitch. Swing and a foul. Runner at first with one out. Fourth inning action. 0-2 pitch coming up here to first baseman Larry C. Kind of a cloudy afternoon. Now into the evening hours here at Tempe Diablo Stadium for this 5:30 start time. Clemens 0-2 pitch is swung on and hit in the air. And, well, another opportunity for the second baseman, McMeans, and that's 2-0. The catcher is Dean Borelli. He's 0-1. Two-down runner at first base here in the fourth inning. 4-0 Houston. Clemens' first pitch to Borelli is bounce foul, and it's 0-1. Our game time temperature at first pitch was 81 degrees, but it's starting to feel a little better. It was a bit humid out here. We were setting up for pregame. You're watching the 28th annual MSBL World Series on APM Video Sports. Roger Clemens. And he delivers low and away, and it's 1-1 on Dean Borelli, the catcher for this Boston Wolfpack team. Todd Edwards, the outstanding shortstop, patrolling that area behind the pitcher's mound currently occupied by the 7-time Gold Glove winner. And here's a rocket that might have hit Edwards in the face, but he stayed with it and got the fielder's choice. What a sensational play by the Houston shortstop. We go to the bottom of the fourth inning. The Stars lead the Wolfpack 4-0. What a sensational play by Todd Edwards at shortstop. That ball, it looked as if it might have come up and hit him in the face, a la the 1960 World Series and Tony Kubek. But he stayed with it, and maybe it did not hit him in the face. He seemed like he was all right as he was jogging off the field. So we head now to the home half of the fourth inning. Houston has scored in each of the last two innings against Dennis Oil Cam Boyd, and now Greg McMeans, the second baseman, to lead things off. First pitch, ball one. It'll be Greg McMeans, Noel Torres, and Jeff McMeans here in the bottom of the fourth inning. 50 and over, American League, 28th annual MSBL World Series on APN. Change up in there, and it's 1-1 on Greg McMeans, who struck out back in the second inning. Good hitter. 6 hits in total for the Houston Old Stars. They have scored 4 times. That's high, 2-1. They've scored 4 times. 3 of the runs are earned against Dennis Oil Cam Boyd. That's high and tight, and he's a pitch away from walking the leadoff hitter. Oil Cam has yet to issue a walk. In fact, both Clemens and Boyd have yet to walk a batter here tonight. The 3-1 pitch, and that's grounded to the left side and past Franquez into left field, a leadoff single. That is the 7th hit of the day for the Houston Old Stars.
Well, a good attempt by Franquez trying to keep that ball in the infield, but could not make a play on the ground ball by Greg McMeans, the 7th hit of the day for the Old Stars. So the leadoff hitter is aboard for Noel Torres, who had a 2-run single back in Houston's 3-run second inning. Swing and a miss, and it's 0-1. Oil Cam Boyd working in inning number 4 and really cannot afford to give up any more runs to this Houston team, especially with Roger Clemens out there. Here's a chopper to shortstop. They'll go 2-1. Can they turn the double play? They do. 6-4-3 variety. And there's 2 down here in the fourth inning, and the batter is Jeff Means, who had an RBI single back in the second inning. So a nice turn out there. John Collins at second base. Franquez, who started the double play with a good clean scoop over to Collins. That'll bring up Jeff McMeans. Jeff is 1-1. And a line shot out into left field. That is base hit number 8. So Jeff Means is aboard. Final hitter in the lineup is going to be Robert Schwartz, who struck out back in the second inning. But remember, it was a swinging strike 3
as he drills one down the line. This ball's foul, and it's 0-1. Remember the play in which Borelli ended up throwing the second because apparently he lost track of the fact that there was two outs in the inning. So Boyd trying to work out of this fourth inning without any more damage. Schwartz at the plate, and he hits one to the right side. Nice backhanded play by C. He'll flip it over to Oil Can, and the side is retired. Good job by the defense. Good job by Oil Can Boyd. But Houston, at the end of four, leads Boston by a score of 4-0. This is the MSBL World Series on APN Video Sports. First time up for Steve Wolf, the manager of the Wolfpack. Batting in the 6B position and the fifth inning of work for Roger Clemens. And the fastball is a called strike, 0-1. It'll be Wolf, Iandoli, and Franquez. Wolf starting in center field today. Takes slow and away. One ball, one strike to the manager of the Wolfpack. There's Steve Wolf out of Wayland, Massachusetts. Clemens rocks and fires. And that one is fouled straight back. Steve Wolf, an outstanding contact hitter. We mentioned Roger has struck out only one. He has not walked a batter and giving up just a grand total of two first inning singles. Here's a fly ball out into shallow left center field, a long run, confusion with the outfielders, and it's off the glove of the left fielder, Fred Gegan, and Wolf is going to end up at second base with a leadoff double. Only the third hit off Roger Clemens here to start the top of the fifth inning, and the Wolf Pack with a chance. That'll bring up Robert Iandoli, a product of Mansfield, Massachusetts. Boston trailing 4-0 in the top of the fifth inning, and the first pitch eludes the catcher, and Wolf ends up at third base. First time up for the 7-slot hitter, the 7B hitter in the lineup for Steve Wolf, who stands down at third base, representing Boston's first run of the contest. Before the double by Wolf, as the pitch is in there for a called strike. He had set down 11 of 12, and the only batter to reach was Herman Rivera, and that came on an error by the third baseman of the Houston Old Stars, Woody Williams. So we're in the top of the fifth inning, Houston with three runs in the second, one in the third, and a pitch that's just off the outside part of the plate. Houston got three runs in the second inning, two on a single by Torres, another one on a single by McMeans. Then they got an RBI single by Roger Clemens as the fastball is high, and it's 3-1. So top of the fifth inning, Diablo Stadium in Tempe, Arizona. A 50-50 chance of rain here tonight, but so far it has been dry, and a beautiful fastball catches the inside corner, and down goes Robert Iandoli. So now the shortstop of the Boston Wolfpack is Miguel Franquez. Slick fielding shortstop for the Boston Wolfpack. 4-0 lead for the Houston Old Stars. Digging in against the hard-throwing Clemens, and he swings and bounces it to third. Williams on the short hop comes up with it and fires on to first. That'll produce the game's first run for the Wolfpack, and the deficit is now 3-4-1. A 5-3 ground out by Miguel produces the Wolfpack's first run, and here is Kamel Assar. Another Massachusetts native. He swings over the first pitch, and it's 0-1. Kamel Assar, Contact hitter batting left-handed against Clemens, the right-hander, in the 0-1 pitch. Called strike. Quickly 0-2 on the hitter. So nobody on, two out. A run is in. And Boston has cut the deficit to 4-1. Roger may have wasted a pitch that time. One ball, two strikes. Dan Cuff is on deck. Clemens looks in, and here's the 1-2. And a breaking pitch. That's major league right there. Second strikeout of the inning for Roger Clemens. Both look caught looking as we have played 4.5. Houston leads Boston 4-1. This is the 28th annual MSBL World Series on APN. Bayside at Waterman's, Galveston's coastal concierge and luxury community overlooking Lake Como and West Galveston Bay. Relax by the resort-style pool, float the lazy river, or fish from the community's boardwalk or fishing pier. Store your boat at the community's covered 127-slip marina. Kayakers and canoeists can launch from the marina on Lake Como or the state park to explore the tranquility of Galveston Bay. Bayside at Waterman's, a rare coastal treasure. For more, call 1-844-9-BAYSIDE. Bayside at Waterman's in beautiful Galveston, Texas. Back at Diablo Stadium, our top of the fifth inning totals have the Houston Stars 4 runs, 8 hits, an error, and 5 stranded, while Boston 1 run, 3 hits, no errors, and they have stranded 3. Well, Cam Boyd in his fifth inning of work, and the first pitch to Rodney McRae is a strike call. Nothing in one on the fleet-footed center fielder. Ready with the next offering, and it's slapped down to first base. A very busy Larry C. takes care of business. Out number one. Todd Edwards, been quite fruitful in his first two at-bats. He has a base hit, a double, an RBI, and he has played outstanding defense at shortstop. The manager of the Houston Old Stars, and the first pitch is swung on and a bouncing ball in the hole, and this will be his third hit of the game. So Franquez had the range deep in the hole, and it almost looked like Edwards came up a little lame on running down at first base. Maybe that left quad giving him a little trouble. And he's going to stay out there. There's no way you're going to get him out of the order. Woody Williams up there, a tremendous career in his own right. 132 career wins, takes strike one called. Good change up there by Boyd. Nothing and one the count on the right-handed hitter. Getting the start here today for Todd Edwards and his Houston Old Stars as Woody gets the start at third. There goes the runner. Pitch is taken. Here's the throw down, a one-hop throw, and a tremendous tag by John Collins. That's big time, no question about it. And that was a tough hop, and he was able to corral the throw from his catcher, Borelli, and was able to lay the tag down to get the sliding Todd Edwards. So two down in the inning. Williams pops it up behind home plate. Borelli near the railing. He reaches up and makes the fine catch, and that will retire the side. So we are heading to the top of the sixth inning. Let's take a look at this outstanding catch by Dean Borelli out of Salem, New Hampshire. As we go to the sixth inning, the Wolfpack will come to the plate trailing 4-1. So we head to the top of the sixth inning, 4-1 Houston. Roger Clemens out for inning number 6. He's given up 1 run. It was an earned run. He has given up a total of 4 hits.
Dan Cuff batting for the first time, the 10B position hitter for Steve Wolf's Boston Wolfpack. It'll be 10, 1, and 2. Chopper foul. Clemens has struck out three. He has yet to yield a walk in this ball game. He has given up a grand total of three hits. We're in the top of the sixth inning from Tempe Diablo Stadium in the 28th annual MSBL World Series. Clemens delivers. Here's a shot and a spectacular catch by the first baseman. Diving to his right, he comes up with it for out number one. Dan Cuff really put a charge into that one, and you can hang a star next to Dan Cuff, or rather the first baseman, Mike Scanlon. So with one down, here's Mark Moyes, who had a base hit on the game's very first pitch. He's one for two and pops up the first pitch in the shallow right. McMeans cannot make a play on it. It's picked up by McCray. And Mark Moyes has two hits in three tries against Roger Clemens here tonight. Those will be bragging rights for that man for the rest of his life. Now Delgado, 0 for 2 against Roger. Infield playing somewhat at double play depth. First pitch, sinking ball. One ball, no strikes. Ramon Rivera is on deck. We're in the top of the sixth inning. Boston trailing Houston 4-1. Runner at first with one out. Here's a high chopper. Shortstop only play is to first base. Good play by Todd Edwards. Two down in the inning. The Boston has a runner in scoring position. And the batter is Rivera. Rivera has been on base both times. He had a base hit back in the first inning. He reached on an error in the fourth. Boston with four hits in total on this evening affair from Tempe Diablo Stadium in Tempe, Arizona, just a couple of miles away from the campus of Arizona State University. And for the second time here tonight, Clemens going through the signs again with Schwartz. First pitch, breaking ball, ball one. Roger, who pitched yesterday and finishing out a rain-shortened game prior to the scheduled game they had at Goodyear, closed it out with the last three innings as this ball is hit well, deep left field, and making the play out there for the final out is Fred Keegan. It's still 4-1 Houston as we head to the home half of the sixth. Well, the cleanup hitter for the Houston Old Stars will start things off here. Bottom half of inning number six, a 4-1 Houston lead. The first pitch bounces up there for ball one. Scanlon, Clemens, and Geegan will be the first three for the Stars here. Trying to go to four wins, one loss, and close out their round-robin play with an .800 winning percentage. They've already clinched a playoff berth. The 1-0 pitch, and that one is popped up left side of the infield, and the third baseman is there, and that's Rivera. Clemens up there for the third time. He's been very successful at the plate over the last 2 days. In that game against the NorCal Stars, he had a couple of big hits. And he is 2 for 2, including an RBI single back in the third inning. Nothing and one the count on the 24-year Major League pitching legend, Roger Clemens. Going up is against his former teammate in that 86 World Series, Oil Cam Boyd. And Boyd not giving him the fastball, a couple of outstanding Major League-like breaking pitches. One ball, two strikes. And the changeup stays way inside. A little brushback pitch. Two balls, two strikes. Let's see if he tries to go the other way with this one. And the pitch is low and away by Oil Cam Boyd. And now 3-2 the count. Payoff pitch coming up here with one out and nobody on in the bottom of the sixth.
And this one is chopped out in front of the plate, and that's a fair ball picked up by Borelli. He'll throw on to first, and there's two down in the inning. So the first time they have retired Roger Clemens at the plate. Two down, and here's Fred Gegan. Fred with a nice play to end the top of the sixth inning out in left field. Has doubled, he has scored. He had a long double to center field over the outstretched glove of Steve Wolf that initially started the three-run second for Houston. That's foul, and the count is even at one ball and one strike. Well, a great night for baseball here at Tempe Diablo Stadium, and so far our fingers are still crossed because they gave us about a 50-50 chance for rain today. And so far that has not materialized. 2-1 the count on Gegan. And he slaps one to second. This should retire the side. It's a 3-up, 3-down inning for Oil Can Boyd. And the Boston Wolfpack, they still trail by 3 at the end of 6. Well, we head now to the 7th inning, and Roger Clemens' evening is over. And he was outstanding. And now Tom Arrington is going to take over and attempt to save the game for Clemens. He had a big save in yesterday's game against the NorCal All-Stars. And he's going to go to work against this tough Boston lineup. And I'm sure a collective sigh of relief when they saw Clemens come out of the ballgame in that Boston dugout on the third base side. Larry C. will start it off. It'll be Larry C., Dean Borelli, the catcher, and then Russo. So Roger Clemens goes 6 innings of 4-hit, 1-run baseball, 1 earned run. He struck out a total of 3. Did not walk a batter. He had outstanding command in this game. As Arrington comes in, back with the next pitch, and it's high. Arrington is a college coach. In fact, he is the current head coach at the same college that Roger Clemens attended before he went to the University of Texas and helped that program win a national title. Here's a swing and a towering fly ball out into left field, under it, and got it is Scanlon, who made the move from first base to left field to give Roger Clemens an opportunity to stay in the ballgame at first base. So Larry C. flies out. He's 0 for 3, and now the catcher, Dean Borelli. Dean takes outside, ball one. I guess there would be a sense of relief that Clemens is out of the ballgame, but I don't think it's going to get much easier with Tom Arrington out there. He is a high-quality right-handed thrower. This one is lifted in the air. First base side, Roger Clemens has it, 2-down. Well, he can hit, he can pitch, and obviously can play a little first base. So he make a couple of good scoops out of the dirt in yesterday's game over at Goodyear. 2-down in the inning, and Paul Russo. Breaking pitch. Might have been a slider that caught the outside corner or kept fastball, one of the two, 0-1. John Collins, slick fielding second baseman on deck for Boston. And going back to that first inning, it's been pretty much dominant pitching for the Houston Old Stars. They have set down 19 of the last 22. Hammered to center field, but McCray is there. And an easy inning for Arrington in his first inning of work, trying to save it for Roger Clemens. His team leads 4-1. It's the 28th annual MSBL World Series on APN Sports. Well, the seventh inning stretch has come and gone, and now we go to the home half of the seventh inning. Jeff Lowry with the call of the game here. Glad you could join us. Beautiful night for baseball. Oil Can Boyd still out there. He's looking and buying for a complete game. As Greg McMeans steps to the plate, and he's ahead in the count 1-0. He slaps one down to third, gobbled up nicely by Rivera, and the long throw across in time for out number one. So an excellent play by the Wolfpack third baseman on a hard hit ball by Greg McMeans, and Torres will bat. He had the big hit in the game, a two-run single back in Houston's three-run second. So Torres up there, 1-for-2, hit into a 6-4-3 double play back in inning number four. Well, since that third inning, Oil Can has been pretty much dominant. That's out of play, 0-1. Since he gave up three in the second and one more in the third, he is pitching two-hit shutout baseball over the last nearly three innings of ball. Inside, Torres, an outstanding hitter at the plate. Of course, when you talk about dominant pitching, Houston has set down 20 of the last 23 Wolfpack players that come to the plate. And a great breaking pitch. And it seems like Dennis has had much better command over the last three or four innings than he did early in the game, and that breaking pitch has just been devastating. Two-strike pitch, and a high chopper towards a shortstop. There's Miguel. He throws low, but it's scooped out by C, and a couple of ground ball outs. That's typical of an Oil Can Boyd outing. And the batter is Jeff McMeans, who has a couple of base hits here today. Boyd seems to be speeding up his tempo here over the last couple of innings, too. That has popped up, and that is going to be playable and just in foul territory. And Larry C. has been extremely busy here today. But Boston needs some runs. They trail 4-1. You're watching the 28th Annual MSBL World Series on APN. It's the Houston Old Stars 4, the Wolfpack of Boston 1, and we'll be back in just a moment. All right, crunch time here for Boston. They got two more attempts to try to cut into that 4-1 lead for the Houston Old Stars. Tom Arrington in his second inning of work in relief of Roger Clemens, who pitched the first six innings, gave up four hits and one run. Arrington in the seventh had an easy 1-2-3 inning as John Collins, who grounded out his first and only time up back in the second inning. Good fastball, inner half, strike called. Stay with us at the conclusion of this game. We'll have post-game comments from the winning side. Breaking pitch in the dirt, and that one skips away. There's a look at your on-deck hitter, Russ Ward. So Wolf at the plate, or check that, Collins at the plate. Made a couple of nice plays out in the field. But is 0-for-1 at the plate. He lines one to second, and may have hit that one off the end of the bat, and it was right to McMeans for the first out here in the top of the eighth inning. So with one down, here's Russ Ward. He flew out back in the second inning to end the second frame for Boston. Boston's only run came in the fifth inning. Ball one to Ward. Leadoff double by Steve Wolf. Now later, Miguel grounded out to the third baseman. Wolf got a good jump on the ball and was able to score, even though Franquez was thrown out at first base. Ward trying to get something going with one out. Nobody on here in the top of the eighth, and Boston trailing by three. And Tom Arrington may have wanted that call from our home plate umpire. Ward leveling the bat a couple of times. Two balls, one strike as Arrington kicks and fires. Here's a ball hit on one hop to the second baseman. Another try for Greg McMeans. Over to Clemens, two down. Clemens and Arrington have been dominant. They have set down a combined 22 of the last 25 Boston Wolfpack. Two down in the inning, and here's Dave Benedict. Benedict in the 9A position in the lineup. He flied the left field back in the third, the only time up here tonight. He hammers it to shortstop, and Todd Edwards makes the play. We're going to the bottom of the eighth inning. It's all Houston. They lead 4-1. Well, Todd Edwards and his team with a three-run advantage as we go to the bottom half of inning number eight. Jeff Lowry from APN Sports, our website, apnvideo.com. Special thanks goes out to Todd Edwards and Jimmy Jump and the Houston Old Stars and Andy Allen. We got a lot of information from the bench coach of this Houston team. Of course, Eric Finley, also the manager of this Houston Old Stars team that originated back in 2013. So Allen is at the plate, batting for the first time. He is ahead in the count at one ball and no strikes. This is the eighth inning of work for Dennis Oil Cam Boyd. And Allen takes outside 2-0. We'll see if the Old Stars are going to add players to the bottom of the order, which is a common occurrence in the MSBL World Series to get players in. Fastball strike, letter high fastball, and it's two balls and one strike on Andy Allen, currently the owner of United Protective Services. And he slaps one right back to Oil Cam Boyd. He's up, he throws, and that is out. Number one here in the home half of the eighth inning. Of course, Eric Finley, the total brain trust of this team, is Bennett Fisher. Now digs in, an attorney at law in the Houston area. Hard-hitting right-hand hitter. And you can see Miguel there at shortstop telling the outfielders to back up. Of course, you got the cavernous dimensions here at Tempe Diablo Stadium. It's 420 feet to straightaway center field. 359 down the right field line as Boyd faces Fisher here in the bottom of the eighth inning with one out. Nobody on. Houston leads it 4-1, and it's popped up. Right side, second baseman drifting out and cannot make a play. Well, somewhat surprising on what looked like a fairly routine play, and John Collins, I think, just simply lost sight of the ball. He'll be charged with an error, and that'll allow Fisher to reach base safely. And apparently, Fisher was batting for Rodney McRae. So he is aboard with one out. And Todd Edwards has been sensational. He is 3-for-3. He has a single, a double, and a run scored, another single, and has been so vital to the success that Houston has had on the field here today simply because of his defense. He slaps one down the line, but it's foul, and it's 0-1 on the Old Stars shortstop. 340 down the left field line, and it's safe to say that the power alleys here, both left and right field, are very close to 400 feet. This is a huge ballpark. You know, I've lived in the Phoenix area since 1985, and I remember Ken Griffey, the first time he took batting practice in this ballpark, which would have had to have been back in 1989, he cleared that center field eye wall. Unbelievable power. And yes, he was only 19 years old. That tells you something. But Todd Edwards is the man of the moment right now at the plate, going up against Oil Cam Boyd. Well, Dennis looking to go the distance here. Bottom half of the eighth inning, Houston with a 4-1 lead over Boston. Boyd comes set. He delivers. A swing and a miss by Edwards. We mentioned his non-fastball pitches have been extremely good. After getting in some trouble in the second and the third innings when Houston scored all their runs. Full count. Runner at first with one out. Boston will have the bottom of their lineup coming up when they bat in the top of the ninth inning. And that's ball four to Todd Edwards. Todd has been on base all four times and now pinch hitting for Woody Williams. Is going to be Joe Milkoon. Outfielder by trade out of Houston, Texas. Takes outside ball one. So the error, the walk, two on with one out here in the eighth inning. Milkoon, director of business operations at Furniture Systems in Houston. And a strike called on a good breaking pitch by Dennis Oil Cam Boyd. Houston has stranded a total of five runners in this game and lead it 4-1 here in the bottom of inning number eight. And another breaking ball. So Oil Can two strikes ahead of pinch hitter Joe Milkoon. Two strikes and pitching to Milkoon. And he lines one towards the shortstop. Frank Keyes on the short hop. He'll take it to the bag for one. Throw it on to first, double play. What a sensational play by the Boston shortstop. And Frank Keyes and the Wolfpack will come to the plate in the top of the ninth inning, needing three to tie. This is the 28th annual MSBL World Series on APN Sports. Bayside at Waterman's. Galveston's coastal concierge and luxury community overlooking Lake Como and West Galveston Bay. Relax by the resort-style pool, float the lazy river, or fish from the community's boardwalk or fishing pier. Store your boat at the community's covered 127-slip marina. Kayakers and canoeists can launch from the marina on Lake Como or the state park to explore the tranquility of Galveston Bay. Bayside at Waterman's, a rare coastal treasure. For more, call 1-844-9-BAYSIDE. Bayside at Waterman's in beautiful Galveston, Texas. Well, it's do or die time for the Boston Wolfpack as we go to the top of the ninth inning. The Boston-based team down by three at 4-1. Carmelo has batted only one time, and he takes the first pitch, and it's a called strike, and it's 0-1. Boston got their only run in the fifth inning. It was a leadoff double by Steve Wolf. An out later, he was pushed across home plate after reaching third base on a ground ball by Miguel Franquez, the shortstop. A ball and a strike is a count on Carmelo Bastian. Right-handed hitter against Arrington and a bouncing ball towards the shortstop. Edwards behind the bag at second. Quick throwing to Clemens at first, and he got it. Hang a star on that one, and here it is again. He fielded that ball on the right field side of second base and threw him out by a good step. And we were just mentioning the fact that Todd Edwards' defense has probably been as important as his 3-for-3 day at the plate, including a walk. That was a spectacular play by the Houston shortstop, and we go back to the top of the order in Mark Moyes, and he lines one to center. And Rodney McCray makes the sprawling catch as he tries to match his teammate at shortstop on the play of the day. So here in the top of the ninth inning, it all comes down to Jose Delgado. Two out in the inning. First pitch, low and away, ball one. Delgado looking for his first hit. Tom Arrington has set down all eight batters that he has faced. And here in the ninth with two out, he delivers a strike, and it's 1-1. Eight up, eight down. He hasn't walked a batter. He hasn't struck out a batter. His team leads 4-1. And the fastball is high. Delgado ahead in the count. Two balls, one strike. Houston with three in the second, one in the third. Boston's only run came in the fifth. And it's outside, 3-1. Herman Rivera is on deck. Top of the ninth inning, Houston in the field. They lead it by a score of 4-1. Delgado is grounded to short, line to second, grounded to short again. He loops one into right center field. This ball's going to get down for a base hit. The barehanded grab by McCray, quickly getting it back into the infield. That is the first base runner against Tom Arrington. And now Herman Rivera, who is 1-for-3. He has also reached on an error and fly to left field. He's also played a pretty good third base. He's made a couple of nice plays. So he's up there with a chance. If he gets on base, the tying run would come to the plate. Runner at first, two out. And he pops it up, and this should do it. Tom Arrington calling for it and cannot make a play. And all hands are going to be safe. All hands are going to be safe. And now, all of a sudden, the Wolfpack with a chance with the tying run coming to the plate in Larry C. Larry is 0-for-3. He's hit into a fielder's choice. He's popped up to second and flied to left field. First and second occupied with two out in the top of the ninth. And it's popped up on the infield. Drifting out in the shallow right field is a second baseman. And Greg McMeans has the put out to put away the Boston Wolfpack. And the final score here from Tempe Diablo Stadium. The Houston Old Stars defeat the Boston Wolfpack 4-1. In our Roger Clemens versus Oil Can Boyd game from Tempe Diablo Stadium. Tonight's Roger Clemens Oil Can Boyd game has been brought to you by APM Video Sports, Ron Rentrope, Gail File on camera, our associate producer, Jimmy Jump. Special thanks to Todd Edwards, Roger Clemens, Steve Lamonti of the MSBL, and of course, MSBL President Steve Sigler. It's time now for our post-game wrap-up. On this October 20th, 2015, Houston with a 4-1 victory over the Wolfpack. A very special night for both teams. A very special night for baseball and the Men's Senior Baseball League's World Series. As we got to witness Roger Clemens and Oil Can Boyd, two outstanding Major League players now retired. But when you talk about Roger Clemens, you're talking about truly one of the top 5 or 10 pitchers and perhaps one of the top 3 or 4 power pitchers of all time. Clemens went 6 innings, giving up 4 hits and 1 run, striking out 3. He's the winning pitcher. Arrington the save. Oil Can Boyd goes the distance in a losing cause. Todd Edwards, the manager, had to be a big thrill playing out here today with your good friend Roger Clemens and getting a win.
Yeah, it definitely was. It's good to get back with old friends that we grew up with, and some of them made a little further than the rest of us, but once we get back to the age we're at, it's always a pleasure to get back and share old memories and the banter that goes along with it, but certainly thank you, yes.
What was the key to Roger's success here tonight?
Well, when he's probably the best pitcher in the history of baseball, I think he just relied on the stuff that he's had his entire career. He worked out a little bit beforehand, but he's just one heck of a pitcher, and it really showed today.
Any idea what he might have been topping out at miles per hour?
Oh, I'd say he probably hit 85, 86 a couple times, but probably set around 82, 83.
Okay, so you guys finish at 4-1. How do you guys look going into the playoffs?
Well, we feel good. We've got some good pitchers. We've got a lot of good hitters that have played professionally, and they're seasoned guys. They have sore muscles like everybody else, but they certainly know how to swing the bat, so we feel very good.
Well, it's been an honor bringing this to you, and we thank you for everything, and congratulations on the win.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Great job out there in relief of the great Roger Clemens. How does that sound?
It was, it sounds real good, first of all. But, it was fun. It was a lot of fun, and just watching him pitch and then being able to come in after him, it was a true blessing. It was great.
At any time, when you were walking out to the mound for the first time after he threw six very solid innings, was that on your mind? I'm replacing a legend here. Of course, you did it yesterday too.
I'm not sure I really wanted to go out there, you know. I mean, there's a lot of people here and a lot of hype, and we wanted to win, you know. It was his game, and anytime a person comes in relief, whether it's obviously for a legend like Roger Clemens, I mean, you want to secure that victory for that man, and I was just happy I could do that.
Well, I know that you coach yourself and you've got a long baseball career. Was there anything that you learned from him during this week?
Well, interestingly enough, I coach at San Jacinto College outside of his junior college, and Roger Clemens attended that junior college before going on to University of Texas. And so we talked a little bit about that, it's just a good thing to talk about baseball on the bench, talk about coaching, talk about past life, talk about some pro ball. I'm going to go home from this tournament and really reap the rewards of having those memories for sure.
Well, it's certainly a great thing for everyone involved. And, of course, Houston wins it by a score of 4-1. Congratulations on the win and the save.
Thank you so much.
You saved it for Roger Clemens.
There we go.
All right.